one of the cops charged with the murder of Mr. Tyre Nichols sent his lifeless body via text message to multiple people, put up his picture for a mask. It's a damn shame. Former Memphis cop Demetrius Haley, one of the fired and charged officers, also took at least one photo of the victim after the brutal attack and texted that photo to at least six people who are currently unidentified. Officer Haley was fired in the days after Nichols died from his injuries sustained because of a traffic stop on January 10th. Let me give you background. The Memphis Commercial Appeal on Tuesday first reported the latest developments and cited a police statement about the violent traffic stop on January 7th. From the Commercial Appeal, it says the statement, which was obtained through a public records request to the peace officer standards and training, was sent by the Memphis Police Department in its request to have now former officers Tadarius Bean, Haley, Justin Smith, Desmond Mills, and Emmett Martin III decertified. On Haley's personal cell, Officer Haley took two photographs while standing in front of the obviously injured suspect after he was handcuffed, the document read. Haley admitted he shared the photo in a text message with five people, one civilian employee, two MPD officers, and one female acquaintance. The memo goes on to say a sixth person was later found to have received the same photograph. Now, what do you think is going on here? Who do you think he's sending the photographs to? He's sending the photographs to other cops. He's sending the photographs to individuals that he wants to brag with about his trophy, which happens to be an unarmed black male that presented no threat. You see, this once again is a cultural dynamic. Was he texting people to help him cover it up? Did he text individuals who would be in charge of maybe perhaps prosecuting something like this? We don't know presently. But we do know he took that opportunity to send text messages to people who he believed at least would find some level of amusement from a body beaten, bloody on the ground. That's sick. These are the individuals patrolling our streets, ladies and gentlemen. Ithaca, New York gave an exhaustive psychological evaluation to everyone who passed their basic training under the leadership of their former mayor. Their former mayor came right here on this show and says 75% of those soon to be cops all failed their psychological evaluation and were not allowed to join the force. What does that say? That says perhaps 75% of officers should not be officers in this country. There's more. The new report at least partially confirms suspicions that photos were taken of Nichols as cops took turns delivering punches and kicks to the restrained 29-year-old male. Body cam video from the police violence on that day showed what appeared to be an officer using a cell phone to take a photo of Nichols while he was leaning up against a police car. Prior to Tuesday's report, there was speculation on social media that officers, plural, were taking photos of Nichols during the beating. So literally, the rumor mill was correct on this one. There's more. The latest update in an investigation that appears to be widening in scope came nearly 1 week after Nichols' funeral was held in Memphis, where his friends and family alongside civil rights leaders echoed calls for federal police reform, specifically the George Floyd Policing and Accountability Act. At least 13 Memphis police employees have been disciplined for their various roles in the beating. At least six other now former officers who have been fired. Haley is among the five former officers who have been charged with second degree murder. This is all sick. This is all sick. It's all cultural and sick. Now, this police department is obviously rotten to the core. You cannot train yourself out of corruption. Doesn't work. That's a culture. If you give them training, they will simply figure out a way to manipulate circumstances to try and not get caught again. You cannot train yourself out of this kind of darkness and dysfunction. And as long as we continue to contextualize these issues as if, oh, these are just a few bad cops out of a lot of good cops. Really? Remember on day one when I said my person in Memphis told me that around 12 cops were actually at the scene? And he said all 12 cops were either aware of what was going to happen or they knew what these cops had in mind and possibly what was going to happen. The bottom line is all of them were okay with it. All right? They were all okay with it. Who brags about something like this? What kind of heart do you lack to engage in this kind of insanity when you have a position of public trust, something that's actually sacred, you have now made deplorable? The industry of policing being judged adversely is partly because of corrupt people like we see today, but it's also partly because of the leadership and the colleagues who are silent, who provide cover for them. Evil does not permeate because bad people simply do bad things. It's because good people sit back and do nothing. Ben, thoughts here?
Yeah, I mean, this story is just absolutely heartbreaking and deeply infuriating, right? Well, like, because look, when I was in the military, I worked with drones. I've seen a lot of horrible stuff, right? And I've seen, in a sense, what is exactly the same thing, where like there are people who take pride in causing death. And there are people who would like, they'll take videos, they'll take screenshots, they'll like keep it right somewhere where they can keep going back to it. Because for whatever reason, they're just super proud about literally taking somebody else's life. And like fundamentally, it is this culture. And like the unfortunate reality is that this culture within the military or within the police, right? I mean, honestly, both. Is structured in such a way that like the structure of the system itself is reinforcing that culture. And the unfortunate reality is when we do coverage like this and we talk about these things and police departments across the country and police officers across the country respond with these like Blue Lives Matter flags. And when they respond with like, oh, how dare you, the woke mob is coming to cancel police officers or something, or like, oh, you're all terrible. They're basically trying to convert the coverage that we do about innocent people losing their lives into recruiting campaigns for the worst human beings on earth to see this, to see that this is a regular thing, to say, hey, look, this is what police officers are getting away with. This is what police officers are doing on a regular basis. They're not even saying that we're lying about their culture, right? They're not even saying that we're lying about what they're doing, right? They're just saying that we should just accept it. That we should just accept that this is the country that we live in. We should just accept that this is how police officers are supposed to work. And this is why fundamentally, like, as you know, as much as the Justice in Policing Act does, the George Floyd Act does, like, it doesn't go anywhere near far enough to fundamentally restructure how safety even works in this country. Because like without like putting in place real structural components to intervene in specific police officers getting hired, in disciplinary actions for police officers, in all of these different things, without fundamentally taking autonomy and power away from police departments, this will continue to fester. Because you're right, there's no training that's gonna change this. There's no procedure that's gonna change this. Police officers break procedure all the time. Procedure is meaningless. If you're like a well-intentioned politician, you can write all the best procedure in the world. You can draw up the perfect procedure. But fundamentally, if the structure internally to the system is not designed in such a way that will actually enforce that procedure, then it's irrelevant. then it's irrelevant and it's meaningless. And so fundamentally, we need like huge structural reforms. And this personally is why I'm an abolitionist. Doesn't mean all police are gone tomorrow, but it does mean that we take money away from police departments, power away from police departments, and reorganize it to things that are more effective, right? Yeah. This was a traffic stop. This was a traffic stop, right? Why can't we just have speed cameras? Why can't we just have speed cameras, right? Yeah. There's just so many layers to this, but it's deeply infuriating because it just shows you like the sick and twisted nature of the types of people that become police officers, where they see a literal, like they see someone's body and their instinct is to take a picture and send it to their friends and their coworkers. It's sickening.
Extremely. And if you believe public safety has to do with policing in your local community, they have already fooled you. Please keep in mind, your police department is one of the least effective dynamics to actually stop or prevent crime in all of your governmental areas. You have a lot of opportunity to expand budgets and protocol within non-policing roles that actually would create public safety.